this point, let's go, Ed.
Hi.
Do the financial report.
I think I've unmuted.
Bill and Austin, you still there?
Can you hear me?
Yes, I can.
Yeah, okay, we're still here. As Betsy reported,
I don't think they can hear us.
A few minutes ago,
I don't think they can either. I'm going to get off.
As we began,
I think I'll call Bella.
Yeah, they can't hear us. Maybe when she did that screen, it blocks us out. I think, man.
Both with our current.
Well, I'm going to call and tell them they got people wanting to ask questions.
Yeah, we can't answer the damn thing. You know, we're already halfway through the meeting. We haven't answered none. Ask nothing.
Began,
thank you.
Just about everything.
I'm going to get off. I'm about call back.
We've incurred a devastating drop in revenue for the first quarter of the operating season, the final quarter of the fiscal year, and it is obviously necessitated and was accompanied by some pretty essential cost cutting to keep us solvent during that period. We've been forced to incur debt through the PPP loan. Ensured a form of debt as well with a reallocation of what had been previously approved capital in Colorado into operating funds so that we can get through this thing. We literally moved from consistency to great uncertainty as we entered the last part of the fiscal year and begin the new one. In terms of the financials, though, the balance sheet coming out of the third quarter, we're in pretty good shape, which is been an enormous help in getting us through the fourth quarter and into the new year. Our cash position is such that we feel that we should be able to get through the upcoming fiscal year and be able to upcoming winter and the early part of the fiscal year and be able to be in a position to begin an operating season for next year. Overall, the CTO balance sheet now is not that different than it was last year because of the cash that we've been able to bring into the loan program. And some other good things have happened. The Victorian event that was scheduled for this year has been postponed, and virtually all of the participants have elected to allow us to hang on to the cash that had been paid for that thing, and that helps us enormously as well. Inventory in the retail area is down, as reflects the current condition of the sales. We do have a lot of celebration merchandise that we'd hope to sell this year, but the 50-year celebration has been extended into the next fiscal year, and the appropriate merchandise we have will be appropriate for supporting that as well. The commission balance sheet is actually in much better shape than it has been for a number of years, thanks to
Roger and Barbara.
Support we got out of New Mexico the last couple of years, and that's positioned us to allow the commission to be able to continue with operations.
Ed, can you hear us?
The end of this fiscal year. And
I don't think they're working on it. I just got off the phone with Bush.
The P&L,
they now know what the problem is, and they're working on it to fix it. Supposedly, they'll make an announcement to us when we can ask questions.
It's dramatically unfavorable when compared to last year. Our revenue is down in the 75% to 80% range. It's just totally devastating. We've been able to do some very, very tough cost cutting concurrent with that, so that we're in a position now where initially the trains we've run to close the current fiscal year have been able to pay for the basic, the very fundamental out-of-pocket cost, which is an important part of being able to operate them at all. Expenses are lower. Again, labor, as you might expect, is down because we basically are doing so much less. We had a slight improvement going into the new fiscal year in our insurance situation, in that insurance is tied to operating revenues and such, and with our reduced revenues, our insurance costs will go down a little bit. It won't go down as proportionately because of some of the minimum premium requirements, but at least we're going to see some relief in there. So overall, our expenses are down to the fourth quarter. We will limp out of FY20 and go into FY21 prepared to deal with some pretty significant challenges, which we'll talk about in the budget portion of the discussion later on. But overall, we've survived FY20, and we're looking towards that. Capital spending, again, has been reduced dramatically due to the shutdowns we had during the fourth quarter. And as we come back up, we're working with shorter labor hours to manage costs there to ensure that the capital that we do have can appropriately support us through the coming year, in the winter and into next year as well. Overall, it's not the picture I would love to have shown you, but that's essentially where we are at the end of the fiscal year. And we'll talk a little bit later about the budget for the coming year. But I would happily entertain any questions you have at this point.
Ed, you mentioned the opening reserves that we need to maintain to be able to start up next spring. I believe in documents you've given us for support with our conversations in the state of Colorado that amounts to something like $950,000. So it's not a trivial amount. It's not that we just walk up to the depot and unlock the doors of every spring. Is this correct? And you mentioned that we are confident of hanging on to, being able to meet that challenge next spring.
Yes, it is. And that I'll be sharing with you that I would ask your endorsement a little later in the meeting reflects that. Again, it's tough because we've worked for several years now toward our march toward self-sufficiency, and this is basically just knocking the legs out from under that. But with some very, very stringent cost management, I feel we'll get through the season and through the winter and be in a position to where we will be able to begin the FY22 season next year.
Thank you. Ed, I would just like to comment on the only reason we will be hopefully in a position to open again next year is the sacrifice the team has made. So my most sincere thanks. We know that it's the staff that's taken a large portion of the brunt of the cuts, and it does not go unseen. And we appreciate the sacrifices they have made to make sure that we operate next year. So thank you all very, very, very much.
I would add that the characteristic of uncertainty has been most difficult for the working folks here. With the lack of clarity that we have in terms of what kind of a business we're able to run this operating season, it's made it particularly difficult for the people who actually present the product. And without them, this would be even worse than it is right now.
Ed, why don't we go on
Hello?
With your report? Or John, do you want to go into the audit report at this point?
Yes, we've got Ron Franz on now.